And when the word has been preached, they are not here, or they are here, but the minds are not here. Then their marriages break anyway. Is it God's fault? Worry about other person. Worry about the person you are. Do you know how sexy is the person who is complete all by himself?
These ones that are not married, they are worrying about the what? Anything that bothers you in marriage is something that either one of you or both of you brought in there.
In the marriage context, we have spoken to the people that are not married in depth today and partly last week. But next week we'll be talking more, and I wish somebody does not miss that one. It's going to be the last session of this series about family dynamics. Mm-hmm. I'm so passionate about people, you know, building up their lives and knowing what they are in for before they get married.
Mm-hmm.
Those that are already married, they must know what they are in for with them, so that they enjoy every day of their lives. Amen.
Today we are continuing. Today we are continuing with speaking on the second part. Speaking on the second part of my message, which is family dynamics.
Yes.
Amen.
Family dynamics.
Wow, what's this now? Okay. Amen. Are you blessed, somebody? Last week we spoke about the importance of being single. That actually singleness is more important than being married. We emphasize how important it is to be single when it's time to be single. And in fact, your marriage is as good as your singleness. The quality of your single life determines the quality of your marriage life. You can never be whatever, your marriage can never be what you did not invest in your life. We spoke about getting to a child, getting married to a child. Amen. Are you blessed by that part? Not every baby that is small, other babies are big. Other children are big, amen. The fact that that child is driving a big car does not make him... But today I'm just going to start to readiness of men.
Hallelujah.
Going to start talking about readiness of men. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Now, I'm going to be opening scriptures as we go. I want to make this a very straightforward teaching that we all pick up something, whether we are married or single or divorced. I want us all to learn something today. Now, one of the things that you will find in this DVD is some points about how to know that you are getting married to the right person. Because getting married is something that anybody can do. But getting married to a right person is something else. And it's something very special. Amen.
Hallelujah.
So now, one of the things I want to continue with, I'm going to touch on some things I spoke about last week. Adam was in Eden. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Adam was in Eden, and we said that Eden is not a geographic place. But Eden is a spiritual place. It's a place that means the open heaven between God and man. Eden means the presence of God. So before God gave Adam anything, he gave him his presence. For this is the first thing that a man needs. A man needs the presence of God before anything else. The presence of God before a woman. Say it with me. A presence of God before a woman. So umuntu omdingayo empilweni, umuntu omhloka mbuthi, umuntu ohlalayo ebukhoneni buka Jehova,
umuntu adulanga mbuthi bamuthi,
umuntu ongahlali ebukhoneni buka Jehova,
uthi asadulanga mbuthi bamuthi,
noma ngaba nezinto ezingakanani,
like abalinthothe,
noma ngaba nemali engakanani,
like abalishethe ngakanani,
uzophikinga, uthi umuntu ohlalayo no Jehova,
hloka muthi adulanga
mbuthi, oh hallelujah. In fact, he found Adam in Eden. So you've got to be found in the presence of God. Don't leave the presence of the Lord to go find somebody. The person that you find must find you in the presence of the Lord. Do not go to the taxi rank to look for somebody. Do not go to Facebook to look for somebody. Do not go to the institution somewhere or the social club to look for somebody. Let the person find you in the presence of God, so that if he finds you in the presence of God, then he will have to find God first before he finds you. If he comes to the presence of God, it means he will be in the presence of God first. Do not now go and say, no, I'm gonna go and I'll get a person,
I'll bring him to church.
Don't find a man that you will have to drag and bribe and convince just to pray. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Find a man you will have to, I drag and bribe and say, if you can go to church today, I'll do this and that for you. If
so, already
on Jalo,
Hallelujah.
So do not leave the presence of the Lord to go and find a person. But let a person find you worshipping. Let a person find you speaking in tongues. Let a person find you lifting him up. So that nobody does better. Hallelujah. Anti namen bazalwane
akhele namen keke mudini
angengizwana abantu abasha noma nhlanje next
botho abantu abanokugula kanje.
Number 2, you know, the person Adam was working for God.
Adam ona sebeletsa mudini.
So the second thing that God gave to Adam,
you know, tempere mudini my feeling Adam
was still not a woman,
inenze isimusadi,
it was work,
inele musebenzi.
Hallelujah. God gave Adam what? Somebody say work before a woman. So young men, listen to me now. You do not need a woman before you work. Ladies, you do not need to go for a man who does not work yet. Amen. Wait for them to do what? Are you sitting next to a young person somewhere? Ask them this question for me. Are you working? If they are men, are you working?
Yes.
And what are they saying?
Bari.
If they're saying no, tell them with a very loud voice, no woman for you yet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ningizwile nabazalwane.
Ngikukhulile nje nabazalwane.
Hayi, let's move. Number 3. Adam was given a job.
Jwala Adam na fuwe msebenzi.
His job was to guard the garden.
Inelora atsireletse.
He was to protect the garden.
Inelora atsireletse tsimo.
That's Genesis chapter 2 verse 8.
Igenese ya bobedi.
Genesis chapter 2 verse 8, if you please open it for me. So Adam was given a job to do what? To protect the work of God.
Una fuwe msebenzi atsireletse.
So before Adam was given a woman,
jwala bila Adam akafuwe msadi.
He was given a job to do what? To protect. Because man is supposed to be a protector. Not a man to tell
you.
I told you, you don't listen.
How mami?
When things are not working out for you, breaking down, you
want a good.
You need a person that will protect you against yourself. Against other women, against a family, against other men out there. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I tell my wife sometimes, auntie, the women talk a lot. Eh? Now you realize, why are they always talking about this particular fellow at work? Every time talking about this fellow. So when it irritates me, I do not go, you know, at the corner and be stressed with you. Who must this guy be? I go straight to her. Where is she? I say, who, why are you always talking about this guy? What's happening with this guy? Now, that is not being jealousy. That's being protective. It's not that I don't trust you. I don't trust those ones that I don't know. Because I give a TV. So I'm protecting you. I trust them. Call me jealous if you want. I'm just doing my job. Then take up your stand and protect those people that God has given you. Hallelujah. It's not being jealous. It's called protection.
Hallelujah.
Baba smile baba.
Baba bososela mntana.
Yes, we're going to put sugar like this in here.
That's why I'm going to get sick.
Oh, next stress is that who's all told about it? Oh, can't take that long to put my eye. Eh, relative. Ah, God, I'm going to show
you.
Sometimes the things you worry about, they really do not there. But my point is, do not die alone. Talk!
Bua!
Amen, Bama Swamai.
Hallelujah.
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 And then the fourth thing I want to talk about is that a man is always addressed in the Bible as a head. Alright?
Hallelujah.
But a man is actually a foundation. Man is a what? Man is a foundation.
Hallelujah.
So a foundation is not at the top, it's at the bottom. And a foundation determines the strength of the building. The strength of the structure depends on the foundation. So man, you are the foundation of your family. Can I hear the man say amen? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So before the building is built, engineers, they first calculate the building before they put the foundation. So they consider whatever that's going to come on the foundation before the building is being built. So what is being built is what was known when the foundation was built. There will be three-story building. There will be this much people sitting in it. This amount of furniture sitting in it. All that weight has been considered when the foundation was built. So when man was built, we were built in consideration of what we are going to carry. So the strength of the
the heaviness that your family goes through as a man, you have been built to handle it. You do not run away, but you face it because you have been built for it. Because all power has been given unto you. That there is nothing that will come against your family that will overpower you. Oh, hallelujah. Church, we stand as a building, as a structure, as a foundation. That there is no weapon formed against our families that shall be able to prosper. Can I hear the man say amen? Can I hear the man say hallelujah? Even that problem that you're facing, it was considered when you're built. Even the challenge that threatens to break down your family, it was considered when you built. You were built for such a time as this. You were built for these challenges. Come up and be strong and say, I can handle it. And say, there is no demon in hand that will break my family. In the name of Jesus, somebody shout hallelujah.
Amen. So we've got to understand.
Unkulunkulu akavele njalo unikeza umuntu.
Udimo hawufi fela umuntu.
He gives you a person that he has really worked.
Ufa ukuthi yamsebenzise.
There's this thing they always say, behind every successful man. Let's think about this. Amen. Let me have a keepers come in front of. Behind every what?
Successful man.
There is a what? No. I'm not sure if this thing really works. Can I have somebody there, please?
A woman?
Yeah. Just make sure you are a woman. Is she a woman? She is?
Yes.
Yeah, it looks like it. You are a woman. There you go. Clap your hands for you. All right. Now, but in behind every successful. Now this one is supposed to be protecting this one. But now when he's in front and the devil comes, and the devil attacks this one,
oh,
he destroys even the same woman. But now this is what the Bible says. God created a male first. Alright?
Hallelujah.
Yeah, the Bible is clear. A male. Because not everybody is a male. As a man. Male, you are a male by birth. But man, you are a man by choice. Hallelujah. So God created the what? The male. God created the male. And after God created the male, God created what? Alright. Now, the woman was created after. And this is for a simple reason that when the devil comes and attacks the woman, then the man protects the woman. Because man is a protector. Amen.
Hallelujah.
And then there are children involved. Do you have any child in this hall? Or they are all outside. I want to show you something quickly. Yes, just come stand here. That when children are being attacked by the devil, the woman carries them. And when the woman is being attacked by the devil, then the man carries everybody. And when the man is being attacked by the devil, then Jesus carries everybody. And when the devil attacks Jesus, then God carries them all. Because a man is a head of a woman, and Jesus is a head of a man, and God is a head of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. So man is a protector. Do not laugh at the woman when she is in trouble, but protect her, because that's what you are built for. We are not having muscles for nothing. We are not having muscles to beat them up, but we've got muscles to protect them. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Man is a protector. Man is a foundation. Are you with me, church? The This is very important. I touched on it last week. God told the man, cultivate the ground. It's one of the scriptures that says in Genesis chapter 2, I think it's verse 4. It says, God created the land, he created vegetation, but it still says there was no vegetation on the land. In chapter 1, it says he created vegetation. In chapter 2, it says there was no vegetation. No, read it. It's there in the Bible. Chapter 1 of Genesis says God created vegetation. And it was good. And in chapter 2, it says there was no vegetation. Why? Because there was no man to cultivate the ground. Question is chapter 1 lying to us? No, chapter 1 is not lying to us. Vegetation was there in the spirit. In chapter 2 is in the physical point of view. Now on the physical point of view, what was in the spirit is not there yet. Because physical, he will first give you in a spiritual form. If you do not receive it in the spirit, you will never have it in the physical. If you do not celebrate in the spirit, you will never celebrate it in the physical. Oh, hallelujah. It was happy after Paris, a child was not told it a monkey by Atanas. Hangi Tatala, Hangi Susala. Do you feel what I'm feeling? You know, when death and when you actually look at your life, what is there I'm celebrating? You cannot see nothing. In the spirit. Oh, there are so many things in the spirit which are not in the physical yet. So we celebrate the things that are not as though they were, before they were. So you've got to drive the car before you can drive it, so that you can drive it. Oh, hallelujah! Now, if you're sitting there, you know, that's why you must just say amen like you don't care. Because some of you, you're not just sitting in the church. You are sitting in your own pajero. So you must experience the thing before it's there. While it's still in the spirit. Are you with me now?
Hallelujah.
All right. Now, in chapter 1, there was vegetation. In chapter 2, there was no vegetation. Why there was no vegetation? Because there was no man to manage the growth of the vegetation. So when there is nobody to manage the things that God spoke about, God makes the things that He spoke not to be there. Okay? When God has given you things, He first wants to see your readiness to manage them. If you are not ready to manage them, they will never come physically, because there's no man to manage it, because there's no man to cultivate it. So watch this: when God gives you a wife, He does not give you a finished product, but He gives you a raw product, so that you can cultivate it and be the woman in your head. All of us, we've got a woman in our head. One person like this and like that, size 20 mama.
Hallelujah.
With the ice cream, hairstyle.
Hallelujah.
With eyebrows like that. You know what God will do? God will give you somebody with hair, so that you can do that hairstyle you want on the hair that is already there. Give you something to cultivate so that you can make it what you want. Amen.
Hallelujah.
My wife is not here now. I'm going to show you my work.
Hallelujah.
show you my work. What you see now is not what I found. I worked on it. I cultivated on it. This is my 11 years of work. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So you work on the raw product that you have until it becomes what you want without criticizing it.
We criticize.
Ah, when I got you, I knew it was a so.
I went up in religion.
I want to buy your first one and when
it's
no, man, you are not cultivating. You are destroying. When you're cultivating,
how look is
you say, you know what? You know what? Let's go to the hair salon. I will pay.
What's that? Get a pata.
I will tell them which is going to chew on your head. And I will wait for you while they are doing it.
So
that you have? What are you doing? You are cultivating. If you do not cultivate, you will not like what you have. And you will envy us.
Hallelujah.
When you busy up, turn down. I went on the steady up. Don't say shitting. No, you don't do that.
I went to say,
you know what? I'm gonna change this hairstyle now.
I've
got another idea. Me and you. It is so nice when put like that. Me and you. We are going to the salon.
We are salon.
We're going to make that hairstyle. Which one? No, no, it's a surprise. You will see when I'll tell them what to do on your head. What are you doing? You are cultivating your
head.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
When the weight starts to go that direction,
hallelujah,
and you don't see what you used to see, you do not just tell it that you are born as
one.
Size 40.
Size 40, mama.
No, you don't say that. You are destroying. But you just say, you know what? This year,
2016,
I'm buying running shoes. And I'm buying tracksuits. For me and you, we are going to Virgin Active, baby. I'm telling you.
Hallelujah.
When we get there, I'm going to pay for the membership. When I get a lap of treadmill, lap and a spinning bike,
when I can
run two ways, 3-4 months, just to get in the gear. So you cultivate what you have. You do not go and beg a lesson about this as cultivating. Cultivate yours. Say amen, somebody. Say I will cultivate mine. Work on your own. So young people, I want you to know that their marriage is not just about holding hands in the mall. When you see us there holding hands in the mall, it's a product of the work that you've been doing. Those who do not work on each other, they do not even go together in the mall. But show me your peggy papa, la pasala na kya molo. Those children, they're gonna look at other people's toys. Amen. So when you get a person,
My daughter, please five, make sure
that
somebody can go to make you better than you used to be. Better in your career.
Hallelujah.
Better in your calling.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You must find somebody that can. And that important thing is that you must find a person that already knows the word of God. Before God gave Adam a woman, He gave him the word. Gave him a what? Gave him a word.
Hallelujah.
And he said, don't eat in
the
tree. Don't do that. The woman was not there. He spoke only to a man. So it's very important that when you are single, you hear God. Somebody said, if you want to change the world, change it while you are single. Because once you are married, it's difficult to even change a channel on the TV. Are you with me?
Hallelujah.
And then now, God says, after all of this, in Genesis chapter 2, He says now, it's not good for a man to be alone. Which man is that? A woman, a man who is in the presence of God, one. A man who is working, two. A man who is protecting the garden, three. A man who is a foundation, four. A man who cultivates the ground, five. A man who has got the word of God. Now that man is not good for him to be alone. I have such men who are still alone here. I'll show you the man that's not good for him to be alone. But if you find a man who is not in the presence of God, you must drag him to go to church or to pray or to sing. Even when if my figure saw you on your and you will
Facebook.
Find somebody who cannot protect you. Find somebody who cannot cultivate you. You are bringing trouble in your life. Can I hear amen, ladies? Yes. You must delete those numbers of those people if they've got nothing of the thing they spoke about. Start a fresh praying. In fact, if you are still a teenager, enjoy your being single. Be properly single so that you can be properly married. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Where are we now?
Not good for me.
Hallelujah. God trusted a single man with all the instructions. God will always finish whatever he starts before he starts it. God never starts what he did not finish. He first finishes it, and when it is good, then he starts it. So when God was creating us, He created us and He finished about us before He created us. Hallelujah. Then He created one man called
Adam,
and now He created one body. In that one body He puts everybody, and then He put one body in the Eden with everybody in Him, and He told one body what to do, so that He was telling everybody in Him what to do. He tells one body, multiply, subdue the land, have dominion. He said that to one person, but to everybody inside one person. Ah, those people are too hot. Switch on the aircons. The aircons are working now, eh? Wow, put your hands together. What's like that? So, in the beginning, God did not create a crowd of people. He created only one person. And He put everything.
everybody in one person. So in one person was all of us. The instructions and the things that God spoke to one person, He was saying them to all of us. When He was saying subdue the land, He was saying that to me too. When He was saying multiply, He was saying that to me too. So He was empowering me in one person. So when one person sinned, all of us sinned.
Let us see.
Okay.
Hallelujah.
And when God blessed one person called Father Abraham, He blessed all of us. We are the seed of Abraham. We are blessed when Abraham was blessed. Abraham's blessings are mine. And it's an amen man call.
Hallelujah.
So with one person, we were all blessed. But when one person fell in Eden, we all fell through him. We all sinned through him.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So God trusted a single man with all these instructions. Do you know why? 1 Corinthians chapter 7 verse 33.
First
Corinthians chapter 7 verse 33
Hallelujah.
Talks about a single man or a single person. Read it. Let it not come from me. Are you there? Read it. Anybody?
But he that is married
can. Aha. That's all okay. I'm just appreciating you.
But he that is married careth for the things that are of the world, how he may please his wife.
Uh-huh.
There is difference also between a wife and a virgin. The unmarried woman careth for the things
that are not married, they are worrying about the what? The question is, what are you worried about? Are you worried about the things of the Lord? Are you worried about, is he going to be having enough money? Is he cute? You know, we've got all sorts of pictures. Some people, they watch all the late night movies, ETV. And then when they go to bed, they dream all sorts of crazy things. Want to say that the Lord is speaking. And you start dreaming all my sons here. Or you start dreaming all my daughters here because you're watching the junk in the at night. That's not the Lord speaking. Is that thing you're watching?
Get to your own.
Amen. Hallelujah. So stop watching those things. Worry about the things of the Lord. Because when you worry about the things of the Lord, the Lord will bombard you with the heavenly things when you're on earth.
Hallelujah.
When God was saying it's not good for a man to be alone, He was meaning that it's not good for all those things that are put on you to be on one person. Because I've put power in you, I've put favor in you, I've put grace in you, I've put my word in you, I've put my instructions in you, I've put my victory in you, I put everything you need in you. Everything that bothers you in marriage is something that either one of you or both of you brought in there. Amen.
Hallelujah.
40 years. You are marrying 40 years of history.
I'm 20 years.
You are marrying 20 years of history that you do not even know. What is that history all about? You're not just marrying a yellow bone. You're not just marrying a six pack. You are marrying history. Somebody say history.
History.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Now that you cannot control
was another person, let's talk about you. Make your history to be something worth telling about. Make your history to be something you're proud of. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Don't worry about the person you're getting, but worry about the person you are giving to somebody you're getting.
Hallelujah.
Don't worry about the person you're getting. Worry about the person you're giving to a person you're getting. Don't be this type of a person who is Adam was busy working the garden, naming the animals. You are a lion, you are a snake, you are a dog, you are a donkey, doing all sorts of things. And he was, while he was busy doing all those things, then God comes and he says, it is not good for you to be alone. It's not him that decided it's not good for me to be alone. So when was that decided it is not good for me to be alone? It's because of that ETV. Let it be God who says it's not good for you to be alone. Counting the lions that give birth. Can you imagine that, walking in between the lions giving birth? You know, making his job, doing his job in the garden. And then God says it's not good for you to be alone. The more you are desperate to get married, is the more you are not ready. You are ready when you are just working and doing your things, not caring about anything. Then you are ready. Hallelujah, anybody is ready in this place. If you are not ready, if you are still worrying and, you know, seeing that one with a cut and ask, hey, Merrick, may begin. You are not ready. You are ready when you look, when you are not busy looking for anything. Because now you're gonna take some umdana band umpinking. Because when what you need a lot of pampering and caring. You know, you've got to be able to be single and be stable by yourself. You need to be able to do things by yourself. You need to be able to take you to McDonald's by yourself and eat that burger by yourself with a smile on your face, without being miserable, without telling the world how frustrating your life is. Enjoy what? A beggar all by yourself. Is anybody here who is able to go on a holiday by himself or by herself and feel like there's nothing wrong? Oh, hallelujah! You are sick, man. It's because you are not insecure. You are insecure in yourself. Don't worry about the other person. Worry about the person you are. Do you know how sexy is the person who is complete all by himself? Who is complete all by herself?
Hallelujah.
No, man, that's not a spouse, that's a patient. Because when inkinga is not with that person, inkinga is with you. Because you are not stable by yourself. In fact, you were never stable when you were single. You always wanted to have a girlfriend, and before he's out, you want another one. Because this one looks like he's already doing something funny. Now you want another one. So because you are using these exchanges, so now what is he doing? What is he doing? Amen.
Hallelujah.
On the phone, when the phone rings there, you are busy. I phone
in law. I got a shame.
Oh, come on, I'm happy. The food.
Ah, well, I'm happy.
Hallelujah. So you, the problem is not with the other person. The problem is with you. Say amen. So now, let's not deal with the other person. Let's deal with you. Be confident in yourself. Be stable by by yourself. Hallelujah. Have God by yourself. And if that person you find in the presence of God, if that person found you worshiping, if that person found you filled with the word of God, there is no person that can leave that treasure for something else outside. There is nothing in there.
I let me not get there.
The problem people will leave you is because there's nothing in there. Be filled by the word of God. Be filled by the worship. Be filled by grace of God. Be filled by the favor of God. So that Mama Muhamba, God Muhamba Muntu, is the heavens walking on earth. And there is no woman on earth that will leave such a man. A man that cultivates, a man that protects, a man that supplies all her needs, a man that is not always there for her. There is no woman that will leave that man. In fact, every other woman will be looking for that man. Hallelujah. So let us work on you so that you know what you are giving in marriage. So that you know what you are giving in marriage. If you can't live with you, if you can't live with you, how do you expect somebody else that will not have marriage counseling? When God wanted to give a woman to Adam, He did not go to the ground and make a body, but He went to the rib of a man. He took what the man already had and built what the man needed. So God never took from him as God, but he took from a man what the man needed.
Yes.
And built what the man always needed. Because when God wants to bless you with something, He does not go and get it from somewhere else, but He gets it from you and He builds it. He multiplies it. He expands it and He gives it back to you. What He already took from you. That is why we're talking of 10% of everything you get. Because God does not want to give you something from the sky. He wants to take 10% of what you already have and He multiplies it, He builds it, and He gives it back to you. When God is talking about 10%, it's not that He needs another money from you. God has got all the money. God is rich by Himself. He has got silver and gold. He can bless you with of what you already have. When it takes 10% from you, He wants you to have ownership of what He built. When He was building a human, He wanted you to have ownership. He wanted you to have rulership. He wanted you to be the king of what He was building for you. When God takes money from you, He wants to build what you need. And when He gives it to you, then He's going to bless you for years. Oh, hallelujah. God would have built a woman from the ground, but He built a woman from what He took from a man. Every time God's going to bless you with something meaningful, He has got to take something from you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now if you give nothing, God will build you nothing. So you've got to present something and God will make it for you. Once He has finished making it up for you, He will still give you. And when the word has been preached, they are not here, or they are here, but the minds are not here. Then their marriages break anyway. Is it God's fault? Is it God's fault that the marriage is breaking? No, it's not. Because God had brought the solution, but you were ignorant. People die for the lack of what? Of knowledge. Marriages are not kept by kisses. Marriages are kept by knowledge. You know this thing. called a person. Very powerful equipment.
Wow.
Need to understand how this thing works. You need to understand how the woman works. Because man and woman are not the same.
You
need to understand how to cultivate each other. How to stimulate one another.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you do not know how to do that, you will leave your yellow bone for a brown bone or chocolate bone.
But against that chocolate bone, look at a brown bone.
You leave your size 30 whatever.
But I would say size 30 whatever.
For a size 60 whatever.
Oh yeah, size 60 whatever.
Yeah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Because we've got to know about the people. So God provides knowledge. If by the time knowledge is being spoken, and now things do not work out, it's God's problem. Hallelujah.
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 So please buy this DVD. Keep on referring to it. Keep on referring to some things that you go through in life. Because things will happen in life. No, for now they are not happening. Now it's nice. Nabo darling, nabo sweetie, nabo
baby.
Give it a few months. Amen.
Hallelujah.
You will remember what I'm saying here. So do not come when things are already broken. Let us learn about them now. And God will always bless us. Give God a hand of praise. I'm done.